is that the Apostle Paul was from Georgia. Did you notice how often he said, reckoned? It was reckoned unto him as righteousness. Hallelujah. That's a Georgia expression. That's a little bonus for you today. So, an angel appeared to me this morning, dressed in this outfit here, and said, oh, I bet you that the program you did Wednesday night on baptism was a prelude to what you're going to do today, because we're having a baptism. And I said,
absolutely.
Is that Nancy? I decided to say, absolutely. So, I'm going to talk about baptism instead of what I was going to talk about, which I already talked about anyway. I want to ask you the same questions I asked Wednesday night. What happens in baptism? What happens when we baptize a child, an adolescent, or an adult? They're reborn. What? They're accepting Christ. We will ask you to turn to Jesus. We'll sound like Southern Baptists and accept him as your Lord and Savior. And the answer will be, I do. Thank you. What else happens at choir? Hang on. Oh, you know, let me check with my daughter, Jamie, who is visiting us from Georgia, raised in the church, never missed a day. Could you tell me what happens at baptism? Or you whisper something to her quickly. Oh, yes! You become a child of God, did I raise her up right? And Jamie, stand up, please. I just want everybody to see who you are. This is who you are. Child of God. What else happens in baptism? Jane, I'm looking at you. She's not looking back. What else happens in baptism? Tell me this. Do we... Yes, Claudia, thanks be to God. Where's Trouty anyway? Oh, I told her to be quiet, yes. Whoa, it's working. I keep repeating that all the time, and she's got it. Sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism, marks Christ on it to forever. Let's say it. 1, 2, 3. Sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Yes, ma'am. Original sin is washed away. What? Good job, Marla. You're getting praise. What else happens in baptism? A lot of things happen in baptism. So much happens that I'm writing an entire doctoral thesis on all the variations that we need to preach on, because you can't preach all the depth of baptism on a baptismal Sunday. And you can't preach it in one Sunday. We're made a child of God. We're washed clean of our sins. We receive the Holy Spirit. Now, all denominations talk about baptism as a way of incorporating us into the body of Christ. And this body of Christ is the body of Christ of Christians all over, of Episcopalians. But all denominations, all over the world, all who've gone before, all who are here now, and all who will come after. As I said Wednesday, so often when I stand at that font baptizing someone, I feel I'm standing in the waters of the Jordan. Along with John the Baptist and Jesus, I'm standing with the martyrs who are baptized in their own blood. They were preparing for baptism, catechumens, and it would take several years. And some of them were martyred, but they were considered baptized in their own blood. Now, and sometimes I just feel like, it's like I feel at Eucharist, that I'm in that time, that Kairos time, I think that's the word for eternity, where we're standing with saints and all the saints of heaven who've gone before and who will come after. Those are the two moments, especially in the churches of today. We agree about being incorporated in the body of Christ. After that, many denominations vary on how they perceive baptism. Some say you have to be baptized in order to be saved. In Georgia, in the South, many people will come up to you on the street as a stranger and say, "When were you saved?" My answer is always, 2,000 years ago. I was saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus on the cross. I was saved by His life. I was saved by His resurrection. And nothing can stop His life in us. And nothing can stop Him from loving us. And we are taught that in baptism. Baptism is a time of teaching. We do the baptismal covenant. One of the cool things the teenagers did with the adults on the ski trip was they gathered around. See, us adults, if we were baptized as children before 1979, we never had the words from this service read over us, and we never took those vows. And so the adults knelt down, and the teenagers who grew up with the 79 prayer book laid hands on them and said these words that we're going to read today in this baptism. What gives me chills? What a powerful thing that our young people have done for our adults. They too are standing in the waters of the Jordan. And in fact, we will be pouring in some water from the Jordan that one of our members brought back to us. Is original sin washed away? Yes. Many denominations would say that. Some denominations don't say that. Some denominations, throughout the year, some people would wait until their deathbed to be baptized because they knew they had sinned and they would sin after being baptized. There's not a lot of unanimity around all of that. As you know, one denomination baptizes people who have died in proxy, if you will, and that's very unusual in the mainline denomination. My point is, the cool thing, if you look in the prayer book, pay attention to the words today as we have this baptism. We're going to cover all those bases. Everything you said today will be covered in the prayer of baptism. Let me just read to you one of the prayers that I will say. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed upon us your service, the forgiveness of sin, and have raised them to a new life of grace. Sustain them, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give them an inquiring and discerning heart and the courage to will and persevere and the spirit to know and love you. As I say the prayer of thanksgiving over the water, we will be reminded of the flood. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. It hovered over all creation. Okay, are they on their way back, Cheryl? Okay. Let one of these acolytes run up and get or walk. You are anointed by the Holy Spirit. In it, we are buried with Christ by his death. Now, Paul, when he talks about baptism, reminds us of the image of drowning with Christ in the waters of baptism and rising to new life in his resurrection. All the time that Paul refers to baptism, he is usually referring to it to support something else. He never preaches a sermon on baptism. It was just presumed. And in his day, they would walk down into water. They'd be submerged into the water and then brought out. So they knew that image. And then a white robe would be put on them, clothed with Christ. You'll hear Paul talk about being clothed with Christ. Don't you want to be clothed with Christ? That's why she wears a white gown. It's a reminder of that history in our tradition that we are clothed with Christ. Do you have to be baptized to be saved? I don't believe you do. Think about the prisoner on the cross. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus says, today you'll be with me in paradise. He was never baptized. Should you be baptized? Yes. Just do it. And we're about to do it now. Are we all here? Can we all come forward, the candidates for Holy Baptism?